So, finally, after months of waiting, I finally gotten my custom bobble motorcycle back. So perhaps in a separate video, I can show you how you can easily custom build a motorcycle like this. Well, despite the fact that I love this Monster Energy Rider's jacket, in a motorcycle like this, I was thinking, you need to have a leather jacket. So I got this awesome leather jacket, really thin lambskin, for just US$250.
What?
That's right, I'm not kidding you. It's Ringgit Malaysia 10. I'll do another episode where you can get such great jacket at this price. Now when you have leather jackets like this, you need to have the sew-on patches with STP, Alpine stars, you know, like them colorful. So I've gotten STP here, gone to the internet, gone to YouTube, and no one teaches how you can iron on all these iron on patches. So most of them are teaching how to sew them on. Don't really like them because this has got a beautiful lining in there. And what I really hate is that you sew through this lining. So it's gonna look like aftermarket. So I decided to go to YouTube and did a lot of searching. No one said that you can iron it on. Some of them say that you're gonna ruin the leather. You can iron them on. So I'm gonna do one live now. Just love the Liquid Moly logo here. So I'm gonna put this on this side. Of course, on YouTube, you have a lot of viewers that teaches you how to iron them on fabric. And they say put cloth on. Here's the trick. You need none of that because leather is really heat resistant. In fact, if you go to certain parts of Asia, when you start buying a leather jacket, you're gonna take a lighter and try to burn it to show you that it's authentic leather and not.
What?
Make sure that you got this all lined up, which I did. Now, so I got this here. So I've got the iron on really hot. Really, really hot. Turn it all the way hot and don't turn it off anymore. And position it where you want it to be. And then carefully just make sure that you do not use cloth but direct onto this because you need high heat. Otherwise, the glue behind the patches like this will not stick or melt. So you need to make sure that your iron-on has this plastic-like glue. Just leave it there. You need to have patience and arm strength to do this. So you notice that I try not to hit this part of the leather, so you can put cloth here if you're worried that, you know, you put the heat there too long. So this is what I do. Make sure the sides are ironed down well, because if it is coming off, it is the side that will come off. So you notice that I make sure that the sides are on well. So they are really secure now. So notice there's no gap. Well, just to make things better, I might run thread just through here using hand-free sewing. So don't even move them. Just leave it there and hold this down. So I've been holding this here for quite a while now. Gonna put the iron away, and here is the thing that I learned. Get something heavy. So I'm gonna leave it there until this glue becomes cool off, and only then you check how well this is. So when I got this jacket back, it looks like shit. I kid you not. What do you expect? The price is like US$250. So you can put your leather jacket into the washing machine and wash them with water. The trick is not to use any detergent, but softener. Just softener and cold water and wash it like usual. And when it's out from the washing machine, do not dry it under the hot sun. It's gonna shrink the leather jacket. And because it's a female leather jacket, it's a little bit short for me. So what I did was I sent it to the laundrette. I told her exactly, use cold water, use softener. The trick that I learned from this lady on YouTube. YouTube is just amazing. There's so much you can learn from it. And I was thinking that I'm going to share with everyone what I learned from this. So when it's out from the washing machine, if you stretch it and pull it, you will make the jacket longer and bigger.
So it was a little bit short for me, so I actually tipped her and told her that you can pull the jacket, and that she did, and I got at least an inch and a half prolonged on the length here, which is amazing.
Well, the stupid of me, I'm going to share this misadventure with you. While I was ironing that and waiting for that to cool off, I accidentally put the iron like so on my glass, tempered glass, 12 centimeter table. And look at that, I forgot about it. I came back like 5 minutes later, turn around, look at that iron on that glass table. And the moment when I turn around, look at it, pop!
Oh no!
It cracked majestically, look at it. So that's the second thing we learned from today, that tempered glass disperses heat like shit. You know what? I'm just gonna take the other patches that I have, the GoPro and the Dunlop, they're gonna go here and here. So I'm just gonna like cover it here so that my wife don't see this shit. She sees this shit, I'm gonna die. Me and my leather jacket have to move out. Hi, honey. I'm just ironing on some. Yeah, you have a good day. That's close. So really, what do you think? I just love it. They're really secure. So I hope you enjoy what I'm doing with this channel here. It's all about do-it-yourself stuff, life hacks, and
oh my god.
I think she saw the cracked table. Hey, how come you cracked the table? Unbelievable, she's gonna kill you.
Whew. She kinda believed that the dog broke the glass table. So I was telling you that I'm not just gonna depend on the glue or the adhesive on the iron-on. So I tried to sew this, so man with needles, we suck. Look, I broke two needles doing this. So I kind of figure out the best way to do this by asking my wife how to do it. So here's the trick. Use double thread. Use the thinnest needle that you can find. You know, you can poke through the patch and the leather easier. And don't use the thread too long. That was the first mistake I made. Just about 50% longer. So you can actually do this by threading this on top of the logo. And once you have that, snip this part off. And then end this knot. Well, my wife kind of think that one single knot is good enough, but I'm not gonna take that risk. So I'm gonna knot this twice. That's what Michelle taught me, is to use a white thread. Start somewhere here. So a round logo is much easier. Now, what I did earlier was that I poke it through here and then try to bend the needle up. That's where I snap it. So the trick is to fold it this way, and when you do it this way, it's doubly hard when you have the pocket here. So it's to fold it this way and then poke it through by bending this. This way you're gonna get the leather but not the liner. That's about it. So I'm gonna check inside that I got the leather and not the liner. That way your needle won't snap. And then grab a plier and pull this out. That is why a surgeon has a hooked suture needle. That way they can like bend it easily. So I should have like gotten that. So it's 10:30. I'm not gonna call my friends, surgeons, and say, hey, do you have a few suture needles to spare? A little bit of search online and found out that you can actually buy sewing needles. These are called C needles. The shape of the alphabet C. They are meant for sewing carpets and leathers. So as you realize, they are crooked so that when you make an entry, it's going to come out easier the other side. So you can actually buy them on Lazada. I reckon it's going to take about an hour per logo. So I'll catch you in the next episode.